What's up, homies? This is Point Man, here to give you a casting of this 1v1 between Portal 2 Samurai versus OTD Deuce Colonel Mustard. I'm just going to call him Colonel, and I'm just going to call this guy Prince of Mastodon. That's it, y'all. Portal 2 Samurai is Prince of Mastodon himself, and I'm going to cast one of his replays that he sent me. And he's going to face Colonel on Crossroads. And let's see their builds. Prince Mastodon has brought 4 bow Ashigaru. Each one is 1 upgrade. He has brought 4 Katana Samurai, 1 Yari Ashigaru. He's brought a ton of Cav. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Yari Cavalry, 1 Light Cavalry, and his General's Bodyguard, of course. And his opponent, OTD, Deuce Colonel Mustard, has brought a very colorful army here. Very interesting. And both of them have very funny names for their units. Like, for Prince Mastodon, he has named a couple units. This one is Robin of Tokyo. I'm guessing Robin as in Robin Hood. He named his general Lionheart. Holy crap, Lionheart the commentator is going to be very excited. No other names. Kenshin's Heroes, he named this unit. Tom Cruise, holy crap, we have a famous actor here participating on the side of Prince of Mastodon. Holy crap, this might be like The Expendables where they have a ton of actors on one side. Anyway, let's look at the other team. I like this unit. Banana Katana. Nice. Big Nasty. Delicious Beast Skills, Bo Ashigaru. Okay, his army is, let's see. I think he is, like, he has hidden units. Let me fast forward a little bit. Make sure he doesn't have any hidden units. Come on. You can move. Come on. And most of his units are upgraded, as you can see. That's why his army is so low in number compared to Prince Mastodon. Prince Mastodon has a very large army, and his army isn't entirely balanced. He doesn't have that many spears as you would need. But his opponent really didn't bring as much cav as him, so I guess he doesn't have to worry about that. Alright, so we did have hidden units. Let's see if he can organize his units real quick so I can tell you his build. Alright, I guess that's good enough. He has 4 bow Ashigaru, and they are upgraded. They each have 4 upgrades each. Not now, Taffington! God damn, go kill Mel Gibson or something. God damn, why are you bothering me? And he has 1 Yari Ashigaru, 1 Lone Sword Ashigaru, 1 Katana Samurai, 4 Yari Cavalry, and they are upgraded. 3 have 2 upgrades, 1 is 1 upgrade. And this guy must be a higher rank than Prince Mastodon, because his general is going to cost more. So that is why the less experienced players have a huge advantage, because they have those big-ass armies. But the thing is, though, the more, like, you're less experienced, so the less knowledge you have of the game. So if you have a ton of knowledge of the game and you are just starting, you are going to be a force to be reckoned with. That's all I got to say. So if I were you players, new players, play on custom battle, play on single player, get used to the game, then go dominate the rest of the matchups online. That's all I gotta say. And this is his army. I really wouldn't take more missile troops than melee. Okay, he has Katana Samurai hidden over here, so I guess he has a grand total of 2 Katana Samurai and 1 Lone Sword Ashigaru. I think he has more soldiers. You never know. You can never know. There's strings all over. People always use stealth and deception in these 1v1 matches. So let's see who's going to attack first, and I can already guess who's going to attack. With a very small army, you really know that your opponent's going to be defensive. You think, I have the smaller force, so my opponent should be courteous enough to just attack. Maybe. But if I had the larger army and I knew I had that numerical superiority, I would want to defend. Use that against your opponent. Doesn't mean you're a noob or anything just because you're defending. You need to have good patience. You need to use your units to their best effect, and you're very wise when it comes to attacking. Alright, so I'm going to speed this up, see who makes the opening moves, and it looks like Prince Mastodon is going to move up his skirmishers. He's not going to move it very organized, he's just going to... First, he's going to target this one Yeriashkara, and this is really serving as a meat shield, so you really don't want to waste your time shooting at these spear units. They're just peasants with spears. So looks like now Prince is going to target each one of these Boashkara individually with his own. And surprisingly, even though Colonel was able to give off the first shots, he is going to lose these early missile fights, and eventually he will start to win them. And I really don't understand this since his units are more upgraded than Prince Mastodon's. Looks like now Prince Mastodon is going to start moving up his melee troops, maybe just get him in position, get him organized before the attack. He has a ton of cav, so in the future maybe he might move on the wings, like, since this is Prince Mastodon, he might move on the wings like Prince Alexander the Great maneuver. It looks like now he's going to send a Yeriashkara, maybe as a fodder unit, just to take up the missile shots. And then he's going to send his Katana Samurai. If I were a colonel here, I would send my Yari Cavalry, my Lancer units, to just deal with these melees, because they are not, they can't contend against cav charges like these spear units can. So if I were a colonel, I would send in a Yari Cavalry charge. What is he doing? Come on, man. Okay, so he's going to be very defensive early on. He's going to take charge of these Yeriashkara from Prince Mastodon. And no, Colonel, you need to send your Yari Cavalry to attack these Katana Samurai. They're just going to destroy your guys in melee since they're not upgraded. With this one extra upgrade and with that charge bonus, they're going to win these melee fights. So Colonel, buddy, what are you doing? Being offensive doesn't give you all these tactical maneuvers and all. As Jay Martin says, attacking means localized advantageous positioning, and Prince Mastodon right now is using all the positioning he can use to get the advantage, and on the drop of his opponent, he's, like I said earlier, I kind of visualized this. He's going to place his cavalry on the wings, and this is too much for his opponent to continue if he doesn't have as much cav as Prince Mastodon. And being the less experienced player here, he spends so much money on upgrades and on his general. So he's not going to be able to contend with all this cavalry everywhere. He's going to get attacked from the flank, from behind here. Prince Mastodon's going to support his guys in melee. He's going to send two each on the flanks. He's going to overwhelm this one Yeri cavalry with two of his own. He's going to do that again on this side of the field. So he's doing that on both flanks, the left and the right. And he's going to send two more to help his units in melee. So I'm going to kind of predict this real quick. Colonel is going to lose the infantry fights, even though he does have his Abner's bodyguard nearby. They're not going to win these melee fights, they're just going to lose, and they're being destroyed from a distance by these missile troops. And with this missile support and superior melee superiority, Prince Mastodon is going to win these melee fights. You might think, oh, he's going to lose them. He's losing them right now, but look, as you can see, they're just dissolving here from these missile troops. And the cav fights is already going to be in Prince Mastodon's favor. He's going to start attacking Colonel's Avatar's bodyguard. And you don't want to leave your guy alone. You want to just run him away. Keep him as live as long as possible. And as I said, the melee fights are done. The cav fights are done. And so all that's left is to rout his Avatar's bodyguard. And Prince Mastodon has done that beautifully. Colonel really did. He had the advantage when it came to quality. But quantity, he was just going to lose. And while you're doing all the missile fights, I think that's really just an illusion or just a distraction just so he won't use his superior missile troops to focus on Prince Mastodon's cavalry or on his melee. He was just trying to make a diversion just so he won't focus all that fire on his better troops. So you gotta hand it to both players. It was a good job, and GG to both players, and thank you, Prince Mastodon, for letting me cast this 1v1 replay. Thank you, buddy.